إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل دلالة في النار وبعد. Then we began by praising Allah, the most majestic and the most high. We praise Him, we seek His aid, His assistance and His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evils of our souls and from the evils of our actions. As Muslims, we believe that whomsoever Allah guides, due to a goodness within their souls, then there is none to misguide. And I bear witness, as Muslims we believe, that whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chooses to misguide due to a perversion or a disease in their souls, then there is none to guide except for Allah. And I bear witness that there is nothing which has the right to be worshipped except for Allah alone. And I bear witness that Muhammad, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, is his slave and his final messenger. The best speech is the speech of Allah. The best of guidance and examples is the guidance and example of the messenger Muhammad. May the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him. And that the worst of all affairs are the newly invented matters. Every newly invented matter is an accursed innovation. Every accursed innovation is misguidance. And every misguidance leads to the hellfire. Then there is no doubt, Ya Ikhwan, that we living in the lands of the West, and we living in an era that has reached a time over 1,400 years since the time of revelation, that in the era and the locations that we live in, that we have become distant, and we have become distant in terms of period of time, and distant in the lands that we live in from where Islam emanated in the time of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that the ummah over the period of time, from the time of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam up until this time, no doubt has been involved or has taken on board, after generation and generation has gone by, that the state of the ummah has deteriorated. And people have departed bit by bit, small amount by small amount, away from the guidance of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when one ponders over why the Muslims in the world today, and that which the Muslims are facing in the world today, meaning not just on the level of the geopolitical arena, not just on the level of the international politics that the Muslims are facing, but just even on a level of one's personal life and one's involvement with regard to his family and one's interaction with other Muslims, that you find that the Muslims are in a state of turmoil, that the Muslims are in a state of difficulty, the Muslims are divided, the Muslims are separated, so much so that one Muslim will walk down the street and not give salam to his Muslim brother, that Muslims who are living in societies and communities since the time of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam till the time that we are living in now, that they have become over this period of time divided and separated and causing and having enmity one to another. And likewise the enemies of Islam, those who wish to extinguish the flame of al-Islam, have utilized that weakness in the ranks of the Muslims and have utilized and taken the opportunity and capitalized upon the weakness of the Muslims. So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith that surely a time will come when the disbelievers, the unbelievers, will take from the Muslim lands just like a guest takes from the food that is placed in front of him. Just like the guest takes from the food that is placed in front of him by his host. And this is the reality that is occurring to the Muslims today. That the Muslims have become so weakened, that the Muslims have reached such a level of impotency that they are not able to protect themselves. That they are not able, even if a nation was to come and overpower us, that we don't have the ability to protect us and defend ourselves. And this overall weakness of the Muslims, there is a cause behind it. Even in the hadith of the Messenger of Allah that I've just quoted, that the Prophet ﷺ said that a time will come when the non-Muslims or the unbelievers will take from the lands of Islam and take from the treasures of the Muslims, just like a guest takes from the food that is placed in front of him by the host. So the companion said, Ya Rasulullah, is it because upon that day we will be small in number? We will be small in number. Look at the thinking of the companions. The thinking of the companions is that we are people of Iman. We are people of Islam. We are people who have submitted our will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are following the sunnah of Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So how is it possible that we are going to be overpowered? How is it possible that anyone can overtake us and destroy us? So those companions were surprised at the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they gave an answer. They said, Ya Rasulullah, is it because we are weak? Our weakness is due to the fact that we are small in number. Is that why they're going to be overpowering us? So the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, rather upon that day, you will be great in number. Muslims today, ya ikhwan, over 1 billion Muslims in the world today. At the time when those companions were asking the questions, one of the great scholars, Sheikh Muhammad bin Saleh Al-Uthaymeen, rahimahullah, from the scholars of this era who passed away a few years ago, he said at the time of the passing away of the Messenger of Allah, there were 114,000 companions. 114,000. So those companions are asking the Messenger of Allah, is it because we are small in number upon that day? He said, no, rather, you'll be great in number, but you'll be like the scum or the dirt, that foam that floats on top of the flood water. That you'll be like the foam that floats upon the top of the flood water. And wahan will be thrown into your hearts. That there'll be wahan or a weakness that is thrown into your hearts. So the companions of Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam absolutely realized that this weakness is not because of a small amount of numbers of the Muslims, but rather the weakness is something else. So the Messenger of Allah mentioned that there will be weakness that will be thrown into your hearts. So the companions asked, Ya Rasulullah, what is the weakness? So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, love of life and the fear of death. Love of life and the fear of death. So the Muslims have reached that stage. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that whomsoever hates to meet Allah, then Allah hates to meet him. And whomsoever loves to meet Allah, then Allah loves to meet him. This is the way, this is the sifa of the believer. So the female companion Aisha and the beloved wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she went to the Messenger of Allah, she said, Ya Rasulullah, who is there amongst us? O Messenger of Allah, who is there amongst us who does not hate death? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is not what it means. What it means is that when the angel comes to drag your soul out of your body, when that angel comes to drag your soul out of your body,